Hey, I'm Connor with GME Supply, and today we're talking safety hard hat standards. OSHA standards state that a helmet must be worn when working in areas where there's potential for injury to the head from falling objects.
There are two types of hard hats classified by ANSI standard Z89.1-2014 for different levels of protection.
Type 1 hard hats are designed to only take a blow directly to the top of the head, whereas type 2 hard hats are designed to reduce force from lateral impact, such as off-center impact, side impact, as well as top of the head. These helmets have a visible padding on the sides. The Petzl Vertex Vent helmet sets a standard for type 1 protection. With a strong chin strap, vented holes, and a 6-point webbing suspension system, this helmet is the preferred choice for comfort and strength. Hard hats must also be worn in areas where there is risk of exposure to electrical conductors, thus requiring a further level of classification. Class E hard hats offer protection from high voltage conductors up to 20,000 volts. These helmets cannot have any vents in the design. Class G hard hats offer protection from low voltage conductors up to 2,200 volts. These must also be free of holes for ventilation. Class C hard hats are considered conductive and do not provide any electrical protection. These helmets are typically vented and only protect the worker from impact.
Petzl's Alveo Best offers similar benefits of comfort and strength as the Vertex Vent. However, with the removal of the vent slots, this helmet becomes Class E compliant.
ANSI requires proper labeling of a hard hat, which identifies the standard to which it was designed to meet. If the label is missing or no longer legible, the helmet must be replaced. Hard hats are not designed to last forever. Service life begins from the time it's put into service, and that date should be properly labeled and documented. Suspension should be replaced after 12 months, and the helmet itself should be replaced after no more than 5 years. If the hard hat sustains an impact, it should be retired immediately, even if there is no visible damage. Proper inspection should be taken each time the helmet is worn. The suspension should be installed and worn as the manufacturer intended. Exposure to paint and chemicals may damage the structure of the helmet. Therefore, steps must be taken to remove paint or chemicals after every use. Pressure-sensitive, non-metallic stickers and self-adhesive tape are typically accepted. However, we strongly recommend you refer to the manufacturer's specifications before applying anything to the surface of the helmet.
For a complete selection of safety-certified hard hats, visit GMESupply.com.
Click our logo to subscribe to our YouTube channel, and be sure to follow us on Instagram, Twitter, and like our Facebook page.